ברוכים הבאים. ברוכים הבאים לכולל ברוך אהבת ישראל בעזרת השם. Welcome to כולל ברוך אהבת ישראל. Today, בעזרת השם, we have a special class for partners in Torah. As we mention every Tuesday, בעזרת השם, Partners in Torah Foundation is about 10 years old, Baruch Hashem. We have the ability and opportunity and merit to be part of them, Be'ezat Hashem, for the last 5 years. Today, Parashat Ki Tavo, and I want to first and foremost dedicate this class to Refuah Shelema, to our soldier, Achayal, the soldier, Bar'el Ben Nitza, Be'ezat Hashem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu Yishmor Oto V'Yirpe Oto. And I want to dedicate this class also to the success of Mrs. Yocheved Bat Devora, Be'ezat Hashem, and we want also success for Yaniv Yaakov Ben Raya with his new baby, Be'ezat Hashem, he and his wife. And Be'ezat Hashem, I want to also say Refuah Shelema to Ori Or Ben Anat, Baruch Hai Ben Chaya Miriam, אליהו בן אביבה, יצחק בן אלה, תמי בת אסתר, מחלוף בן משה, יהונתן בן אורלי, פנחס בן רחל, קרן בת אליזה, שולמית בת ציפורה, בתיה בת אורה, בת שבע בת עזיזה, משה בן מרסל, והצלחה לויקטור שלום, בעזרת השם בכל אשר יצליח יעשה. And בעזרת השם also, we want to dedicate this class to honor of my parents, בעזרת השם ניסים בן פרחיה, אבי מורי הקדוש, זיכרונו לברכה, אמי מורתי רחל בת רוחמה. And בעזרת השם, we also want to dedicate this class to my brothers, בעזרת השם, זיכרונם לברכה, מאיר אברהם בן יעקב, הקדוש ברוך הוא בגן עדן תנחה את נשמתם. Alright, so בעזרת השם, again, we want to say thank you to all our sponsors, Mr. and Mrs. Selwyn Isako, Be'ezat Hashem, Refuah Shelema, and Hatzlacha with everything. We want to also thank all of you for being with us. Please do share this class with everybody, Be'ezat Hashem. And if you could kindly, please, if you could have the ability and opportunity to promote our class to everybody, send it to everybody. We greatly appreciate all of that. And Be'ezat Hashem, we want to make sure that all of you and all of us are blessed with a wonderful week and a wonderful Hatzlacha. So, Parashat Ki Tavo. This parasha, as we know, is actually the third parasha of month of Elul, and we are, as we say right now, in the month of repentance and Hatzlacha. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu says in the Torah, V'haya ki tavo el ha'aretz asher Adonai Elohecha noten lach. So we know V'haya is in the words of God. V'haya is the letters of Hashem, Yud Hei Vav Hei, and meaning that, you know, when you come to this earth, we are going right now, we'll speak about what the Kabbalah says when it comes to this parasha. The Kabbalah says, basically, when you come to this world, אשר אני נותן לך נחלה וירשת וישבת בה, you came to this world and you settled in this earth, I want you to know that you're here to basically collect the fruit of the earth. So the fruit of the earth, we'll see in a minute, is really our mitzvot, our good deed, and everything that we do in our lifetime. And of course he says, ולקחת מראשית כל פרי האדמה, bring from everything from day one. And when you come up back, as we know, our neshama goes back, then you will show HaKadosh Baruch Hu all the mitzvot you've done. Those are the fruit of your labor in this world, because nothing else you take with you. This is in the Kabbalistic part of our parasha, but we say here that after all said and done, Hashem says when you come to the land of Israel, you know, the people of Israel now, this parasha, is really before the entering to the land of Israel, and it's exactly the year 2488. And now Kadosh Baruch Hu says, "Ki tavo el ha'aretz asher Adonai noten lecha." I'm giving you this land. It's very interesting. The word "ki tavo" in gematria is 439 years. This is exactly the moment they're about to enter the land of Israel, and as we know, Kadosh Baruch Hu promised Abraham in Brit Ben Abetarim that on the 440 years, the people of Israel will come to the land of Israel. And that's exactly what's about to happen. On the 15th of Nisan, the people of Israel will come to the land of Israel. So we know that, what does it mean that HaKadosh Baruch Hu promised Abraham? So we know in Brit Ben HaBetarim that happened to the date, 440 Shana, 440 years, when HaKadosh Baruch Hu says to Abraham Avinu in Brit Ben HaBetarim that I will basically will give you the land of Israel, right? And he says you will receive, the people of Israel, your children will receive the land of Israel, both sides of the river, on the what we call the west side of the river, Ma'ever LaYarden, the Hainu Yusham Sheva Medinot, there'll be seven nations. And on the other side, there'll be three nations on the east of the river. And that's exactly what we have. And of course, he says that after that, that will be exactly 440 years. The people of Israel came out of Egypt from the 15th, Tedvav Ben Nisan, 2448, 40 years in the desert. And before that, that was 400 years exactly when the Brit Ben HaBetarim happened, when the covenant with Abraham happened. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, I will give him to you. And of course, it's very interesting, you know, though, as we say, Gimatria Kitavo 439, and it's exactly Moshe Ben Yocheved. And today we have the merit to bless a wonderful new father, Yaniv Yaakov Ben Raya, בעזרת השם, הקדוש ברוך הוא יזכה אותו ואת אשתו בתינוק או תינוקת קדושים בעזרת השם. He says, בגימטריה also, מעבדות לחירות is 439. So we see that הקדוש ברוך הוא now is giving the gift of the land of Israel just like he promised to Abraham Avinu. And we see here that it says, ולקחת מראשית כל פרי אדמה אשר תביא מארצך. So, you know, the Zohar הקדוש says, you bring everything that you came to this world. The mitzvot, you bring with you. כל מה שאתה בא לעולם הזה לעשות מצוות, לוקח, זה הפירות מראשית, מתחילת, מתי שנולדת. And בעזרת השם, we see here, it says that you come and you bring ושמת בתנה. תנה, by the way, is a basket, סל, you know, בתנה in גימטריה is also 60. 60 כנגד 60 מסכתות. You have to learn Gemara. יש בתלמוד 60 מסכתות. כרגע יש 63, במקור היו 60, originally there were 60 trackets, and then they added 3, it's called the Babot, Baba Kama, Baba Metzia, and Baba Batra. He says, put batene, tene, 60 in Gematria. He says, you have to come and show Hashem everything you learn. This is your perot, reshit, everything you bring from the beginning. And he says, והלכת אל המקום אשר יבחר אדוני, Elohecha leshaken shemo sham, and you go to the place that Hashem resides. So we know HaKadosh Baruch Hu male kol haaretz kevodo is everywhere, but of course we have what we call Gan Eden, what we call, this is the heavens where Hashem kisei hakavod sham ata ba velaraot lo et kol ha-mitzvot. You're going to come and show him everything that you've done. So we know that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he says that, you know, when he promised Abraham that his people will be the children of Israel for 400 years in slavery, the Zohar HaKadosh says, and the Gaon Chida brings that, he says that when Hashem wanted to reduce the amount to 210, he come to Abraham, he said, Abraham, can you donate a letter from your name? Abraham says, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I had Abraham, you added hay, I don't have any extra. Come Yaakov, he says, I used to be Ekev. I held in the Ekev, in the heel of Esav. You gave me the letter Yud. I don't have extra. Shalom Aleichem, Adon Biton. Thank you for watching with us. And Be'ezat Hashem, came Yitzchak Avinu, and Yitzchak says, you know what, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I want to donate a letter. HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, great, what is the letter? And of course, he says that Yitzchak says, one day, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he said to him, you called me, אשר קראת את אברהם ושבועתו ליצחק, בשין, not יצחק. יצחק says, take the shin, give me the tzaddik. So you know, shin in gematria is 300, tzaddik is 90. 300 minus 90, 210. יצחק אבינו, reduce the rate of 210. You see, but ברוך השם, יצחק, by the way, we see in our parasha also, there is 98 curses, חס וחלילה. We'll see, we go through the parasha, the blessing and the curses, and Har Eival and Argrizim. But after all said and done, the 98 curses, Yitzchak Avinu was trying to remove them. Yitzchak mufia b'Torah 98 pa'amim. 98 times Yitzchak appears in the Torah. Keneged 98 klalot, to help the people of Israel. So we know here that we have to bring the bikurim, of course, the tene. You know, in the old days when Bet HaMikdash exists, three times a year we got to bring the bikurim. And of course, this bikurim had to be done on Sukkot, Pesach, and Shavuot. And we used to come and bring the first of everything that you bring. So we know the Kabbalah says something amazing. It says, what are these so-called hamakom? Hamakom is really Beit Avod Shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu. There is a place, one of the seventh heaven, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It's called the Devir. Sham HaKadosh Baruch Hu Nimtza. He says that, you know, there was one rabbi, Yoshua ben Halevi. Yoshua ben Halevi is one of the 10 people that went to the heaven alive. Hu nichnas legan Eden b'chayav. And hu haya Tana Kadosh. And Yoshua ben Halevi wrote a book. The book, it's called Sha'arei Gan Eden. Is he described Gan Eden? What is Gan Eden? So he writes like this. He says, when you come to Gan Eden, there is shtei petachim sha'arei kedechur. Shnei sha'arim, im ma shenikra even shayish aduma. Ve'yesh b'Gan Eden, 60 ribo kitot malachei sharet. There is 600,000 angels of Hashem. That actually, each those are 600,000 kitot. Kita is usually over 21. So imagine the numbers of malachim. V'chol echad mehem ziv panav mavhik kezor arikaya. And each one of them, they light up the whole heaven, so to speak, with light. And he says, when the tzaddik comes to Gan Eden, they take off his clothes from the grave. You know, when we are buried, אנחנו קוברים עם תחריכים. בא המלאכים מורידים את בגידי התחריכים, they bring the person to Gan Eden, and מלבישים אותו שבע, they dress him with seven kinds of clothing. It's called בגדים של ענני כבוד. They actually dress the person, the צדיקים, with seven garments. And those are what we call Anane Kavod, and those are from the clouds of glory, Anane Shechina. As we know, when the Mishkan and the Bet HaMikdash exist, there was four Ananim on each side, north, east, west, and south, and one above and one below, and one above all. Seven Anane Shechina, they dress up the Tzaddik, ונותנים בראשו שני כתרים, and they put two crowns on the head of the Tzaddik, one of Avanim Tovot ומרגליות, one, it's actually made out of beautiful gems, diamonds and such. And one, Echad Shel Zahav Peruvim. It says gold and this. Then they give Shmoneh Hadassim Beyado, Umekalsin Lefana Veomrim Lo, Lech Echol Besimcha Lachmecha. They put crowns on his head of the righteous, the tzaddik, and then two crowns, I'm sorry, dress him up with seven kind of holy garments, and they give him eight hadasim, is the myrtle that we smell, the nice hadasim that we use for Havdalah. And they go, said to him, go enjoy now, go eat and enjoy, and bring him into a place, mukaf benachale maim. It says, they bring him to Gan Eden, yesh arba'a nechalim shemekifim, there are four rivers that surround Gan Eden, a river of milk, a river of wine, a river of parsimony, and a river of honey, dvash shel tmarim. And in that Gan Eden, it says there is 800 mine arazim. There is 800,000 trees. Vekol etz yesh bo perot. Every tree has fruit and hadasim and vradim. And he says when they bring him there, he says, from those 800,000 trees, there is 8,000 trees that all of them meshubachim mikol atzim. There is 8,000 that is like the most blessed trees in Gan Eden, and each one has fruit that none of it like the others. Shmone elef atzim perot shekol pri lo taim kma sheni. Kol daze tochal tehene. Bgan Eden en lo mashminim. En kaze dav. אוכל כמה שאתה רוצה, בופה עד הסוף. So it says here, בגן עדן, He says, after you eat all that, you go to the center of Gan Eden, ve'etz ha'chaim be'emtza. There's in the middle of Gan Eden, there is the tree of life. And we know, etz ha'chaim hila machazikim ba. We're all part of this tree, the tzaddikim. And he says, ve'esh bo shmone me'ot mine ta'amim. In one tree, there's 800 different flavors, and none of the flavors is the same. 800 different smells, and none of the smells is the same. Ve'lo dibiyono ze dome ledibiyono shel ze, and nothing looks the same. Everything is different. Ve'esh bo memchet anafim. There's 48 anafim branches, major branches. And he says, "V'kol echad kemale olam is the size of our earth. Kol anaf the godel shel kadur haaretz." ומתוך שבע ענפים למעלה נאמר עץ חיים היא למחזיקים בה, ולמעלה שבע ענפים, another seven branches that size of the world, and this is the tree of life. He says that when you go to the heavens, if you did the mitzvah bikurim on earth, and you were a tzaddik, and you kept all the mitzvot, the sal that you bring, the tene, is filled with mitzvot, and allows you to enter the highest breath of the heavens, Be'ezat Hashem. So we know that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is give the opportunity to the people of Israel to do the Bikurim. You know, this parasha, the first mitzvah is Bikurim. The whole parasha has six mitzvot. Yesh rak shesh mitzvot ba'parasha hazot. Lo kmo parasha she'avra ki tetze 77 mitzvot. 77 in ki tetze. Here only six. The six, there's three aseh and three lo ta'aseh. Three positive mitzvot you shall do, and three negative mitzvot you shall not do. And the first mitzvah is Bikurim. And the first Bikurim that ever happened, by the way, is only mitzvah you can do in the land of Israel. And the first Bikurim is basically after 14 years. And Be'ezat Hashem, the people of Israel, when they came to the land of Israel with Yoshua, Refuah Shlema, when they came to the land of Israel with Joshua, we know that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave them, as we call, 7 years to conquer the seven nations. Ayu sheva shanim nilchamu v'chilku et ha'aretz. 7 years they divided the land, and then they planted. And after 7 years, it was 14 years, 7 and 7, they brought the Bikurim. It's very interesting, the first pasuk, the first verse in our parasha has 14 words in it. 14 milim ba'pasuk arishon against those 14 years. Each word is a year, and there was the first Bikurim. As we mentioned, Bikurim, it says, it's a gift to Hashem, la'avi mitzvot la'Hashem. And the whole idea of the Bikurim is emunah, because you know, when you, after you do the Bikurim, you understand, you bring the firstborn. But davar arishon shta mevi, ze ma shenikra ha-bechor. כמו שאמרנו, בכור בגימטריה 222, the בכור is the firstborn. The Gemara will tell us that actually when you go to bring this gift to Hashem, what do? You actually go to the field and you mark the first fruit that comes out. This is the fruit of שבעת המינים שנשתבחה בהם ארץ ישראל. Of course, it's the fruit of the חיטה, שעורה, גפן, תאנה, רימון, Zeit, Shemen, Udvash. So we know those are the seven species that was blessed in the land of Israel. And you have to go and mark it. And this is really to give to Hashem the first thing. That like Hashem does for you, we do for Him. And He saved us. Of course, Makat Bechorot, as we know, on Mitzrayim, it was against our Bechorot. And of course, He said these seven species, they have seven Sefirot. Those also resemble the seven attribute of powerful divine attribute that Kadosh Baruch Hu protects both the earth and mankind. It says Shivat Aminim. Also, they have the seven, as we call, Sefirot. And as we know, those Sefirot, we have the Chesed. Chesed is, as we know, this is the kindness, you know, that has basically the loving and kindness. And that's against Avraham Avinu. As we know, we also coming towards the Chag of Sukkot. In Sukkot, we have the seven Ushpizin, the seven visitors that come to visit us, against Shivat Aminim, against Shivat HaSefirot. Those are the seventh. And Avraham, as we know, he comes against the Chesed on the first day of Sukkot. And then we have Gevurah, which is basically the judgment, and this is the amazing power of Yitzchak. He is against the Gevurah. And then we have Tiferet. Tiferet is the beauty of Yaakov Avinu that was always strong, and Nivchar Avot, he was Tiferet Israel. From him will come the 12 tribes. Then we have, of course, Netzach. Netzach is the eternity, which is Moshe Rabbeinu, Torato Emet, and Navi, as we know, for the one, the only one that was merited to bring the Torah from Shamayim. And of course, we know that the other one is Aharon, Avinu. Aharon is Hod. Hod, he was dressed in Bigdei Kehuna, and this is the what we call this is the splendor of Hakadosh Baruch Hu, the High Priest. And then we have Yosef, which is also Yesod. Yesod is the foundation, and we know Yesod is also Yosef was able to control himself and never ever sinned with the wife of Potiphar named Zulicha or anything like that. And of course, the last one is King David. As we know, Melech David HaMelech, King David, he is the kingship, and this is, as we know, Malchut. This is the attribute of Malchut. So we know when we bring the Bikurim, we really honor all our forefathers, and we see that, you know, by bringing the Bikurim, we tell Hashem, thank you. The first thing that you give us, we want to give to you. It's really is a emunah, it's a faith, and a very, very blessed thing. They said the Gaon Chida, by the way, Zichron Bracha, Rabbi Chaim David Azulai, he was the student of Rabbi Chaim ben Atar, Or Chaim HaKadosh. He says that Rabbi Eliyahu Navi, as we know, Tana Deve Eliyahu, Eliyahu Navi says that when there is no Bet HaMikdash, it's a big mitzvah to give gifts to Talmidei Chachamim, to, you know, go to your city where you have a rabbi, Talmidei Chachamim, yeshivot, go there and give them gifts in lieu of the Bikurim. It's a big, big mitzvah. He says, this is what he says, the Gaon for Chida says, Eliyahu Navi says, Shedoron letalmidim, Chachamim mechaper avonot. You know, when you bring gifts to yeshivot, to Talmidei Chachamim, to the rabbis, to their kollels, this is actually kaparat avonot. You are allowed, especially on the month of Elul, as we know, Tzedakah Tatzil Mimavet is a month where you can give Tzedakah and change the decree. He says, what is this mitzvah? The Gaon Chida says, V'samachta b'chol atov. You should be happy with all the good and make other people be happy too. So the whole essence of Bikurim is to give to Hashem, but to also give others. As then we know, he says, Klomar, she'im yecharev habayit ve'lo yu Bikurim, tismach b'torah. He says, if there is no Bet HaMikdash, as we know, it says, Ivdu et Hashem besimcha. This is the simcha, is to give gift to Talmidei Chachamim. He said, this is really considered Bikurim. This is exactly like you went, imagine when you go to Bikurim, when you go to give the gifts to Hashem in Bet HaMikdash, imagine cities all over the Israel in the old days. Nobody had any security alarm or gates. Everything was open. The people from each city gather all the gifts. They used to send messengers and go up to Yerushalayim, and all of them come from all over. They say Nabikurim, according to Melech Yanai, King Yanai, wanted to one see how many people arrive for Bikurim. It was 12 million people come from all over the world for Bikurim. And of course, it says that when they come there, everybody there welcome them. The Gemara will tell us in Masechet Bikurim, it says that when they came to Yerushalayim, they were waiting, and HaKadosh Baruch Hu was sending the people of Yerushalayim. Everybody has to stop and welcome this amazing, amazing celebration. And people that came back then, there was no cars, no airplane, nothing. People walked and either rode their donkeys or, you know, everything that has to do with carrying their stuff. The Ashirim, the rich people, used to make a basket out of gold and silver. The poor make it out of, trees or knesuf or anything like that. So we see that this opportunity here, the Bikurim, the people of Yerushalayim came and start welcoming everybody, singing to them, and making sure they have everything that they need. And of course, the bringing of the Shivat Aminim, as we know, when Moshe Rabbeinu sent the spies to the land of Israel, and 10 of them spoke ill of the people of Israel and the land of Israel and of Hashem, really. They spoke ill of everything that HaKadosh Baruch Hu promised. And they brought back anavim, grapes, gefen, right? They brought back the big vine of the wine, the grapes. They brought with them te'ena, a fig, and they brought with them rimon, pomegranate. It was giants. Imagine 4 of them. I had to carry just the one branch of vine, of the grapes. 2 of them carry one pomegranate, and 2 of them carry one, what we call, te'ena, fig. They wanted to scare the people of Israel. The Zohar HaKadosh says they did that because to remind of the sin of Adam and Chava. As we know, Adam and Chava sinned with the wine. And then they wore the bigde te'ena, the leaves of the te'ena. Te'ena from what we call le'it onen. They were making complaints for no reason. And of course, they lost all the rimon, the mitzvot of the rimon, as we know. And it says that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, now by doing the bikurim, you do really a tikkun for the meraglim. It's a big, big mitzvah to do bikurim. This is how you atone for the sins of the spies. And as we mentioned before, the word tene is 16 gematria against all the 60 masachtot, that a person has to come to heaven's men, especially, of course, to come and learn Talmud. You have, can do daf yomi every day, Be'ezrat Hashem. It's an easy thing to do. And you can learn a daf a day, and Be'ezrat Hashem, you'll come to Hashem with the tene, with those gifts that you bring in. Of course, in Gemara, in Masechet Bikurim, in page 83, the Torah, the Gemara will tell us how to do the Bikurim. As we mentioned, you go down to your field. If ra'ita mashu te'ena, o kol peripri she'idchil eshkol she'bachar, rimon she'bachar, koshro bechut le'siman. When you see the fruit comes out from the 7 species, you tie a little ribbon around it and you mark it as the firstborn, and this is the one you need to take. And of course, you have to bring all the people from every city, and people that don't have fruit, they can make a donation to the Beit HaMikdash. And of course, then they carry it all the way to Yerushalayim. As we mentioned, everybody comes, and when they come, the people of Yerushalayim, they are actually singing the song of Arumcha Adonai Kiddilitani. This is the prayer we do every day. By the way, it's one of the mizmorim of Tehillim. And of course, they say even the King Agrippas, you know, there was a Melech Agrippas. He loved this amazing, amazing holiday. He used to come out from his, what we call, Armon, and used to carry baskets on his shoulders to help the people that come to Yerushalayim. And Notel et HaBikurim al Ktefav. And he says that when they got there, the people of Israel that waited in Yerushalayim, and the Levites, Alevim, Ayu Sharim, Shlosha Yamim Shel Bikurim, Be'ezrat Hashem. And as we know, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, as we mentioned, we have here everything that has to do with the blessing and the cursing on Mount Gerizim and Mount Ebal. By the way, Mount Gerizim and Mount Ebal, they are right of by Shechem today. Yesh ma shenikra mitzafon zehar Gerizim, midarom zehar Ebal. Ebal, by the way, is evil in English. Evil come from the word Ebal. It was curses that were cursed there. 6, as we know, 6 tribe war on one side and 6 tribe on the other. Shisha Shvatim, the Gemara will tell us also in Masechet Sota how the process would go. It says, Shisha Shevatim alu l'rosh ha-grizim, v'shisha alu l'rosh ha-reival. It said the 6 and 6, by the way, if you look at the Shevatim, the tribes that were divided, it wasn't according to their mother's birth, they were according to the sin of Mechirat Yosef. The Zohar HaKadosh says that how did Moshe place them and order Yoshua to do when he came to the land of Israel is according to how they were involved in the cell of Yosef. איך היו, באיזה רמה ובאיזה קרבה היו לחטא מכירת יוסף. So you had six on the right, six on the left. And of course, he says, in the middle, the Gemara will tell us in Masechet Sota, that for in the middle, between the two mountains, there will be the Kohanim and the Leviim and the Sanhedrin. And then when the Torah will read to us the blessing and the curses, as we know, it says that when you stand in front and whatever you do, you say this, and this is again tikkun lemechirat Yosef. This is to atone for the sale of Yosef. And the Torah will tell us exactly how they go about it and what they need to do. It says, Vayitzav Moshe et ha'am bayom ahu lemor. Ele ya'amdu levarech et ha'am al har Gerizim. These are the tribes, the heads of tribe that will stand on Mount Gerizim. By the way, Gerizim in Gematria is 260. Which is actually Har HaMoriah. Moriah in English, I mean in Hebrew also, 260. And of course we know that why it's 260, the 10 brother that sold Yosef, they wanted to honor the name of Hashem. So as we know, Gerizim 260, 26 times 10. And we see here that Moshe says, these are the one that will stand on the right mountain of the blessing, Har Gerizim. And they are Shimon ve-Levi, Yehuda ve-Issachar ve-Yosef. I'm sorry, ve-Binyamin. So we know that here, you know, Hashem does not put Ephraim and Menashe here. We see this Yosef and Binyamin. Of course, they came from the mother of Rachel. And then on the left side for the Klala, there were what we call Behar Eval Reuven, God, Asher, Zevulun, ve-Naphtali. And of course, he says, the first thing he says, ve-Amru el kol ish Israel, kol Ram. They have to start now. And if we notice here, it starts with the curses. It says, Arur ish Asher yase pesel u-Masecha. Cursed be the one that would do, God forbid, idolatry. And of course, everybody has to say Amen. And the Kohanim and the Levites and the Sanhedrin will stand on the bottom and face the mountain that says the curses on Eval and the mountain that says the blessing on Gerizim, and they'll say Amen, and the people of Israel will say Amen, of course. And it says, Ufatchu biklala. Why? Because of what happened. Yosef was stolen from Shechem, and now, as we know, Yosef, when he died, he asked them to bury him in Shechem. He says, Mishchem lukachti. We know that when Yosef died, he, in his will, he was actually swore the people of Israel to return his bones. And of course, we know Moshe Rabbeinu went with Serach, the daughter of Asher. She revealed to him that the bones are in the Nile, in the Nilus. And he said, Ale, Shor Ale, and he rose the casket of Yosef, the Miraz of out of Mero. And as the Egyptians sunk it in the Nilus to have blessing, of course, the questions ask why Yosef did not want to be immediately let out of Egypt like his father Yaakov when they took him when he died. They say Yosef wanted to stay there to protect the people of Israel in Egypt. Mele male tzadikim kvurim bekol haolam leatzil et hayehudim shenimtzaim bagalut. This is really, even the Rebbe Melubavitch, Zichrono Livracha, he also remained in New York, as we know, in the East Coast to protect. We have rabbis in Morocco, in Tunisia, in all over the world, in Europe. They are there to protect the people of the Israel, wherever they are in the exile. And of course, the Torah will tell us that now with the tikkun of Yosef, they will do these curses, and that's when the people of Israel, the Zohar HaKadosh says, Arevim ze lazeh. The Gemara will tell us after they did the curses and the blessing, they become each other's grantors. And it's like receiving the Torah again. As we know that HaKadosh Baruch Hu set them up in a way that it's not like the mothers and fathers, like the way they were birthed. Of course, we know Yaakov Avinu, all the 70 people that went to Egypt, Shivim Nefesh, 66 came down with him, and four were there already. Yosef was not, Ephraim and Menashe. But the other 66 came with him. And we know that Yaakov had all 60. We know that the brothers, the 12, the brothers, they had also, as we know, they had twin sister. Every tribe that was born, Reuven, Shimon, Levi, Yehuda, Issachar, Zevulun, they all had twin sisters. And of course, Dinah was the seventh daughter. And Bilhah, Dan, and Naphtali, that's, you know, and of course, they had twin sisters. And that's, you know, Zilpah, Gad, and Asher. They had twin sisters, Rachel, Yosef, and Binyamin. And of course, we know that when the Torah says that Yaakov Avinu went to Egypt, Yaakov, Vayered Yaakov Mitzrayima, Im Kol HaNefesh Yotzei Yerech Yaakov. All the people were his children. And back then, remember, the Torah did not, was given yet, and there was no Isur of marrying daughters, and that's how we know from Adam Arishon, Cain and Hevel had daughters, sisters, I'm sorry, married their sisters, not their daughters, my mistake. So it says here that Rashi explained, by the way, in Ma'amad Har Grizim and Har Eval, he was receiving of the Torah again. He says, Shezu nitna b'shalosh britot. It says three times they received the Torah in three places. One in Mount Sinai, Be'oel Moed, in when Moshe Rabbeinu gave the Torah. The second time it was in Mount Gerizim. And the third time before that was in Arvot Moav. As we know, Moshe taught the entire Torah for the last 36 days of his life, from Aleph Bishvat until Zayin Be'Adar, until the 7th of Adar, 36 days. And we saw Ele Hadevarim, Ele Gimatria 36. And of course, we know that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, by the way, as we mentioned before, our four mothers that we have, the wives of Yaakov, is an acronym Barzel. Hence is the Kippat Barzel. Barzel is our mothers that protect us. We know Barzel, Bilhah, Rachel, Zilpah, Leah. And the Torah says that when it comes, to the mitzvah of Hasket, you know, the Torah says that you have to do Katuv, when you have to do this hasket in the Torah, is Aseh Lecha Kitot Shel Talmud Torah. You know, hasket is from the word kitot. This says you have to make this mitzvah of creating Talmud Torah. And that's what we said, we have to really understand that after you came to the land of Israel, and after you did the Bikurim, and after you had blessing and curses, but right before that, we know the Torah says that you have to basically shamor et kol ha-mitzvah asher anochi metzaveh etchem. You know, HaKadosh Baruch Hu says to the people of Israel and to Ziknei Israel, the Sanhedrin, to make sure that they keep all the mitzvot. As we know, the Sanhedrin was the rabbis of Israel. You know, every head of a tribe used to be a rabbi, but also the Shivim Zekenim, they used to be the Sanhedrin. And it says that in a place there were no Kibud Hashem, Uchaz V'Chalila Chilul Hashem, the Gemara says in Masechet Eruvin, in 63, page 60, Samech Gimel, it says the Gemara, B'makom Sheyesh Chilul Hashem, En Cholkin Kavod L'Rav. So Chaz V'Chalila, if you have a place where the rabbi, you know, allow people to come to shul on Shabbat driving or get to the Torah while they're Chilul Shabbat, it says, Asur, lo cholkim kavod l'rav. You're not allowed to even consider them a rabbi. And it says, why? This is what Hashem says, because this is the mitzvot Hashem gave us. The whole Torah is considered one mitzvah. Of course, we know that after all said and done, we know that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is giving the opportunity to the people of Israel to receive the blessing. Because right now, after they go to the land of Israel, there will be no clouds of glory, there will be no Shekhinah, there will be no well of Miriam, there will be no man coming from the heavens. Now they have to earn their keep, so to speak, and they need the mitzvot. And the mitzvah of Bikurim allowed them to really honor Hashem. By the way, we're coming upon next year, Ishnat Shemitah, Tafshin Pei Bet. This is our Shemitah, and this is really, really amazing. The Chafetz Chaim, Zichrono Livracha, Rav Israel HaKohen, he said something amazing. He said that after World War II, after seven Shemitot, Mashiach will come. He said that's when Gog and Magog will start. This is, again, this is a Chafetz Chaim, said that in 1945. He said that, before that he said that actually, he says there'll be a World War, and after that, 10 Shemitot, 70 years, and then will be Gog and Magog, and Mashiach will come, and he said it will be on Sukkot. And again, this is what he said. I just want to bring it up to your attention, and I hope not, there'll be no war, but you know, just Mashiach, Be'ezat Hashem, but we have to be ready. He says in the Torah, Baruch Ata Ba'ir Uvaruch Ata Basadeh, you bless in the city and you bless in the field. So the Zohar HaKadosh says Ba'ir is this world, and Basadeh is the world to come. As we know, the Sadeh, Masbirim Chazal, Masaret Avodah Zarah, our sage says in the Tractate of Idolatry, he says, Ve'alehu lo yibol v'chol asher ya'aseh yatzliach. It says, of course, whoever stick to the Torah and keep the mitzvot, mishpatim and chukim, it says his so-called aleh, his leaves will not die, so to speak. And everything that you'll do, you'll be successful. So Rabbi Yoshua ben Levi, as we know again, he's one of the 10th people that went to the heavens alive and saw the heaven and came out to tell about it and went back. And he says that whoever deal with the Torah, the prophets, and the writing, so to speak, both written and oral Torah, it says, Nechasav matzlichin lo. He says, this is the source of Parnasa, is, as we know, Talmud Torah keneged kulam. It says also, Vehi sha'amda, as we know, David HaMelech would reveal to us. What's Vehi sha'amda? Vehi is Vav He Yud Aleph. Who is she? It says really Vehi is Vav, is the Mishnah, the six Sidrei Mishnah. He is the Torah, the five books of Moses. Yud is the Ten Commandment that we obligated with all 613 mitzvot. And Aleph, of course, Elohim. We have to always, always, always honor Hashem in everything we do. And it says Ve'al Yedei Limud Torah Lehagdil Et Hamichsa LeParnasa. He says, how do you get Parnasa? As we know, Parnasa is Parnas Hashem. Hashem give you according to your level of Torah. And of course, I always say a joke. In English, we have a word called business. Business is two words in Hebrew. Bezeh, nes. It's a miracle with business. Many people that, you know, have no idea how to do, they're very successful. They don't know how to read and write, have everything. People have five PhD, has no jobs. It's really according to your level. And of course, it says when you do this Hasket Ushma Israel Hayom Venieta Le'am, it says when you start putting yeshivot together, when you do kolels, when you do that, it says in the Gemara, why? You do this Le'adonai Elohecha. The Gemara says in Masechet Brachot, it says Rabbi Yehuda, it says that Chaviva Torah al Lomdeha Bechol Yom Veyom Shenitna Mehar Sinai. How blessed is the people that learn Torah, that Asu Lahem Kitot Kitot. It says, why? Because in order to get to the Torah, you have to have a Chavruta. Right? It says, Shlosha Dvarim were giving with what we call Yesurim. Shlosha Dvarim Nitnu Be Yesurim. As we know, is those are the three things that given are in a very hard way, in pain. Achat, when David HaMelech says, Achat Shalti Me'et Hashem, what's Achat? As we know, Aleph, Eretz Israel, Chet, you know, Achat, Chet, Zechaya Olam Abba, and Taf, Torah. Those are the three things that's very, very hard with a lot of Yesurim that we get it. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, I want you to know, when you deal with Torah, you'll be blessed. Even we know that it says, in the Torah here, it says that Hashem will bless the womb, or, you know, the fruit of your womb. Baruch peri bitnecha. So we know our sages explain what is Baruch Pitnei, you know, what is the blessing of the womb. So we know, of course, it's a beautiful, good, healthy, holy children. Bezat Hashem, that's a great blessing. And it says, even the goyim, even if a goy that loves Hashem, Hashem blesses them. You know, when David HaMelech was bringing the Aron HaKodesh, was bringing to Yerushalayim, and it fell, and two people tried to pick it up, they died. And David HaMelech put it in the house of a goy, but the goy that was very righteous and loved Hashem and loved David HaMelech and the people of Israel, his name was Oved Edom HaGiti. Oved Edom, he was Edomite. And he lived in the city of Gat. Gat is really, by the way, it used to be one of the cities that the Philistine took from Israel. You know, Azza, Gat, you know, those are the Ashkelon. There's five cities. Only Azza belongs to them. But back then even, we see that the Philistine took the city of Gat. And one guy named Edom, his name is Oved Edom. Oved, he loves Hashem. And he actually guarded the Aron HaKodesh. And when he guarded the Aron HaKodesh, the book of Shmuel 2, second book in chapter Vav, it says, Vayvarech Adonai et Oved HaEdomi ba'avur Aron Elohim. Hashem blessed him. How did he bless him? Oved's wife and eight of her, what we call kalot, their daughter-in-law, his daughters-in-law, and his wife, all of them gave birth to six tuplets. Kol leida yaldu shesh. David HaMelech ראה את זה, הלך והביא את ארון הקודש לירושלים. By the way, King David bought Jerusalem with money, just like Abraham bought Me'arat HaMachpelah, just like Yaakov bought Shechem. Those are areas they bought because they knew that it will be contested in the future. And we see, אנחנו רואים שהקדוש ברוך הוא לא לחינם ציווה את האבות שלנו לקנות את הערים, את ירושלים. דוד המלך קנה את חברון מערת המכפלה, אברהם, ואת שכם קנה יעקב. ידעו שיהיו בעיות שם בעתיד. It's exactly what's happening today. So we know this is the blessing of the womb. And it says, of course, because of Oved האדומי הגיטי, he was so protective of Aron HaKodesh, he was blessed. And of course, it says here, ונתנך אדוני אלוהיך עליון על כל גויי הארץ. So the Zohar Kadosh says that when the people of Israel, Elyon, when they're with Hashem, when they are elevated, Hashem protects them in a way that they have what we call Tzelem Elohim al Penehem. They have the sign and the look of God on them, and the Goyim will fear, will be very afraid of that. He says, why? He says, the Zohar Kadosh, וראו כל עמי הארץ כי שם אדוני נקרא עליך ויראו ממך. He says that when the goyim sees the people of Israel, they're afraid of them. When they're close to Hashem, how they're afraid of them? He says, "Tzelem Elohim al penehem." He says, "What's this tzelem?" He says, "When people are righteous, in the old days, the tzaddikim used to go to war with tefillin on head and tefillin on hand, and they used to war, and the goyim used to see the tefillin, they were terrified." That's why we know in the Torah there is five wars. The people of Israel went to war and nobody died. Not even one person, not even wounded. It was tzaddikim, because tzelem Elohim alehem. It says the Zohar Kadosh, when we see that, you know, we read tipol alehem ematav afachad, bigdol zeroacha, the zeroa is the tefillin, of course the zeroa of Hashem. ואז יבלו אלפי אדום, אלה מוהב, יוחזם ורעד, נמוגו כל ישבי כנען, טיפול עליהם, ממתיו הפחד. It says, all the nations will fear you when you are with close to Hashem. You know, the story in the Gemara brought to us about Rabbi Shimon HaTzadik, HaKohen Gadol. Shimon the righteous that was a tzadik, for 80 years he was a Kohen Gadol in the second temple. And when Alexander from Macedonia, Alexander Mogdon, when he came to destroy Yerushalayim, he came and he was standing with all his military on Mount Olives, Behar HaZitim, and he would look over the temple and they get ready to go and destroy Yerushalayim. And he started heading down to the valley. Shimon HaTzadik saw that and he put on the Kohen Gadol, the clothes of the Kohen Kohuna, all eight garments, and he went down to, and he had the tzitz of Hashem, Shem Hashem HaMeforash, on his forehead instead of the tefillin, and he went down. And when Alexander Mogdon, Alexander from Macedonia, was one of the 10 kings of the world, saw him, he started bowing to him. Mishtachave ela, mishtachave, mishtachave. Everybody says, you know, to him, what are you doing? Why are you bowing to this, you know, Jew? What is wrong with you? We're coming to destroy Yerushalayim. So Alexander says to them, I want you to know, I pray to God to win before we go to war. And every time I pray, I see the face of this tzaddik. He helped me. He was my inspiration and my sign from Hashem that I will win. And of course, Alexander the Great did not destroy Yerushalayim, and he helped Shimon HaTzadik. And Shimon HaTzadik, as a thank you, said to him, from now on, we'll have our children called Alexander. That's why Alexander comes, the Jewish name is from Shimon HaTzadik, honoring Alexander the Great. Of course, he would be murdered later on, Alexander the Great. Very young, he died, I think 32 years old. But let's continue. It says, when you have Hashem's fear and respect, the goyim will fear you and respect you. And that's what it says. It says in the Torah, Im kishem Adonai nikra alecha v'yir'u mimcha, they will fear you. We see today in Israel, we have no fear. The Arabs, the goyim, they have no fear of Israel. Why? Because you have 80% don't even act Jewish. The other 20%, unfortunately, have a lot of bayot, machloket, between even the religious people. It's not good. And Hashem says, if you don't have Tzelem Elohim, they will not fear you. And if you do have Tzelem Elohim, this is really how you're going to be protected. And we learned that, they said, the Zohar HaKadosh, that brought to us by the Alshech HaKadosh, he says, where do we learn that? From the two sons of Noach. As we know, Noach had Shem Cham and Yafet, and when he got drunk after the Mabul, he was naked, and his two children, Shem and Yafet, covered him and did not look at him and walked backwards because they saw Tzelem Elohim, and they wanted to respect both their Tzelem and his Tzelem. And of course, his son Cham did not do the same. And he was cursed to be a slave. He was the first Cushi, by the way, in the world. He was the first black person in the world because he had relationship in the dark, in the ark, was not allowed, and he came out black. And as we know, because what he did to his father, he castrated Noah. Noah cursed him to be a slave to his brother for eternity. And the fourth generation will be, actually all four generations of Islam will suffer. And this is exactly what's happening until today. He says, Or HaChaim HaKadosh says, V'ra'u kol ame ha'aretz. He says, this is the mitzvot. When you keep the mitzvot, the nations of the world will respect you. And we see that all the time. And Chaz v'chalila said, Or HaChaim HaKadosh, Rabbi Chaim Atar, he says, Ha'meta'ev et ma'asav, ma'avirin mimenu et ha'tzelem. A person that doesn't keep Hashem mitzvot, or does the opposite of all the lo ta'aseh, Meta'avin ma'asav, it says ta'ava, these are horrific things, is actually looks like an animal. And animals attack animals, right? But why animals attack people? Because they don't see person, they see an animal. Because Tzelem Elohim lo mufi alav, it says the Zohar Kadosh and Rabbi Or HaChaim ben Chat, Rabbi Or HaChaim HaKadosh, Rabbi Chaim ben Atar says, when Hashem remove the image of him from a person is because the person does a lot of bad things, and they are looking like animals to other animals. Amazing. So of course we know we're coming now to the 98 curses in our parasha. Unfortunately, this parasha has the most curses in the Torah. 98 curses. You know, those 98 curses, as we know, we read this parasha before Rosh Hashanah. And of course, Ezra Sofer says that this parasha, by the way, he was also a Kohen Gadol. Ezra Sofer said this parasha came before Rosh Hashanah in order to tichle shana veklilotea v'tachel shana ubirchotea. So the year of the curses should end and we'll come to a year of blessing. And we know we had a lot of curses this year between the corona, between Meron, between the fires, floods, everything that's happening all over Israel, all over the world. This is a year that's really, Elohim Yishmor, a lot of curses. Why? Because we are so far from Hashem, both the Jews and the Goyim. The Gentile and the Jews are so far from Hashem, and Hashem's give a sign, disasters that above nature, anything that is above nature is sign from Hashem. Everything that nature is chesed of Hashem, when things happen naturally, is really is a miracle that Hashem let us see every day. We just don't see it. And of course, after all said and done, we see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is now, he doesn't want these curses to happen to us, but he wants to warn us, look what could happen. As we know, in Parashat Bechukotai, there are 49 curses. And in our this parasha here, we have 98 curses. So altogether, we have basically 157 curses. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he says, the curses, I want you to know about them. But be careful, chas v'chalila, not to bring them to fruition. And it's very interesting, you know, these 98 curses happen to the people of Israel every time we assimilate it with the Goyim. Throughout the history of Israel, whenever, you know, of course in Egypt, and then later on, and everything that happened to us with the Holocaust, and everything happened to us with the Romans and the Greeks, and the Crusaders, and all of this, Elohim Yishmor, many, many of those are big, big problems that happened to us. Why? Because of what we've done. We assimilated, we left Hashem, these curses happen. And of course, we know that in Parashat Mishpatim, by the way, it says, "Ki tikne eved ivri shesh shanim yavod uvashana shviit yetze lachofshi chinam." So we know that when you have a Hebrew slave, after 6 years you have to let him go. And of course, this the Zohar Kadosh says, "Shesh shanim yavod bachshviit chinam" is really as a gilgulim also. A person can come in reincarnation in another person 7 times to this world, 6 times to this world, and if successful on the 7th, yeh chofshi en chinam. So why chofshi? Chofshi is free, chinam is without pay. Why the Torah use chofshi en chinam? The Baal HaTurim says when a person fixed his life, he have up to 6 times. To come as a tikkun. If he succeeded, the 7th is we know, Sha'olam Shekulo Shabbat, Zavat Chalav Dvash Sofei Tevot Shabbat. Shabbat is really Olam Shel Olam Abba Gan Eden, is all Shabbat. And we see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is now says, on the 7th you'll be free, and Chinam, you without pay. Chinam is really Gematria 98. Chinam is really the curses of 98 curses, you'll be removed from them. You will not have these curses. And you'll see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu says basically, after all said and done, I want you to know that the curses that's here, are. I want you to relieve yourself from them if you stick to the Torah. And of course, the last Klala, as we know, that we have in our parasha, is really, first and foremost, throughout this 98 curses, there's a lot of things that's horrific, horrific. Usually, they say there's a very big tzaddik has to read this parashot, this read the Aliyah of the Torah, and we have to really understand that when we are listening to Hashem, we can avoid all these, you know, curses. And you know, this curses is the entire Aliyah of Shishi, the sixth Aliyah. The reason they put it in Shishi, as we know, when you bring somebody to Aliyah of Shishi, is honorable. You know, as we know, the Gaon Chida said that today, even in his Daf, in his Devar Torah Yomi, the Gaon Chida says that a sixth person that goes to the Aliyah, Shishi is Shai, and Shai is a gift. Twice, right? 620. Shishi is Keter. A person that is tzaddik can handle reading this klalot, these curses. And of course, it's all the way through the entire Aliyah of Shishi. And it says that what's the last curse that we have in our parasha is really the curse of Avdut. It says that Chaz v'Chalila, is the word, by the way, is in verse Samech Chet, which is Sach. Sach is also Chas. HaKadosh Baruch Hu has mercy on us. He says, unfortunately, if you are really cursed, the worst curse is to be a slave. Yeshivcha Adonai Mitzrayim be'oniyot baderech asher amarti lecha lo tosif od lirota ve'hitmakartem sham le'oivecha le'avadim u'leshfachot ve'en kone. He says, Chaz v'chalila, the worst curse is to be a slave. Because slaves have no rights, nothing. Whatever the master said to do, they do. They have zero rights. And so Hashem says, I want to avoid those. Im shamua tishme'u, be with me, listen to me. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu even revealed to us in this parasha about the other religion. You know, Hashem says, Chaz v'chalila, if you don't listen to me, he says in Pasuk Samech Dalet, right? He says, Ve'ifitzcha Adonai bechol ha'amim mikzeh ha'aretz ad kzeh ha'aretz. Ve'avadetem sham Elohim acherim asher lo yadata. Ata ve'avotecha etz va'aven. God says that if you don't listen to me, I will spread you around the world and you'll be among people that has a fake religion, the religion of the stone and the religion of the wood. But first is the wood, etz va'aven. Ma ze etz va'aven? Etz is wood, is Christianity, the cross. Even is Mecca, Islam. He says you'll be spread all over the world, chaz v'chalila, between the nation of Islam and the nation of Christianity. That's exactly where we are. This is Hashem, give us the Torah. This was given 3,333 years ago. 2,448 to the Jewish count. Hashem already revealed to us there'll be two fake religion, man-made religion, the Torah says, the religion of the wood and the religion of the stone. And this is Etz Va'Even. And of course, we have to be very, very careful. It says that because we don't keep our sha'arim, it says, V'hatzer lecha bechol sha'arecha bechol artzecha, asher Adonai noten lach. You know, we have to understand, we have the land of Israel as a gift, is Yerusha. But whenever we don't behave properly, we are removed from the land of Israel. Ze kara lanu kvar anachnu ba galut, you know, we are in the Gola 1953 years now. Even though we have the land of Israel today, it's still Gola, there is no Bet HaMikdash. 1953 shanim anachnu kvar ba galut. Ve'ma ze Gola? Gola ze geula bli alef. When we don't have Elohim with us, we are in the Gola. When we have Aleph Elohim, we are in Geula, in redemption. So Be'ezat Hashem, Hashem is giving us the opportunity to really make everything that we need to succeed and not have the curses through the Torah. It says, you've seen everything, kol hamasot hagedolot, asher ra'u einecha ha'otot v'hamoftim hagedolim ahem. And he says, I want you to know, you've seen, all of you, even though you think you haven't been there, but yes, our neshama, being on Mount Sinai, we seen the mitzvot, the kolot, we saw the voice of Hashem, we saw this, all the miracles, the masot, the nisim gedolim, kriyat yam suf, ve'esar ha'makot, kol ma she'hakadosh baruch hu asa lichvodenu. And he says, why? כי נתן אדוני לכם לב לדעת ועיניים לראות ואוזניים לשמוע עד היום הזה. Until today you'll know it. And that's exactly today. We still, Baruch Hashem, learning Torah, doing everything we can to get close to Hashem. So Be'ezat Hashem, I want you to know that HaKadosh Baruch Hu really does not want to chaz v'chalila, you know, curse us. He wants us to know about the curses. שנדע מן הכללות, אבל כמובן כתוב, הנה אני נותן לפניכם היום ברכה וכללה. Hashem has the blessings and a curse. Choose the blessing. And of course, we are finishing with, of course, after all said and done, ושמרתם את דברי הברית. דברי הברית, this is really the Torah. It says, הזאת ועשיתם אותם למען תשכילו את כל אשר תעשו. If you keep with Torah, you'll be the smartest of all nations. And that's exactly we see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave us this merit of being smart, navon, chacham, chacham, ve'navon, bagoim, lo itchashav. He says, we, even though we consider smart and things, but when we are with Hashem, As we know, Am levadad ishkon, bagoyim lo itchashav. When we are with Hashem, badad is gematria 10, meaning 10 commandments, 613 mitzvot. And we know that this parashat klalot, the klalot sheyesh baparasha hazoti, יש 676 מילים. In these curses there are 676 words. Why? Because Hashem appears in this klalot exactly 26 times. 26 times, and Hashem in gematria is 26, yud hei vav hei. 26 times 26 is 676. Hashem says, use my name, use my commandments. I gave you life. 26, as we know, this is how, when do we get the Torah? After 26th generation from Briyat HaOlam. Moshe was the 26th generation. Stick to Hashem, stick to the Torah, stick to Moshe. These curses could be eliminated just through that. So Be'ezat Hashem, I wish you all of you Gmar Chatima Tova, Shana Tova, ובעזרת Hashem שכולנו נמשיך לחזור בתשובה. ולזכות את כל עם ישראל למשיח. I bless all of you, בעזרת השם, to continue with תשובה and to receive a wonderful outcome on Rosh Hashanah, and חיים, and הצלחה, and פרנסה, and בריאות, and רפואה שלמה, בעזרת השם לכולם. Again, I want to bless and ask Hashem to have mercy on בראל בניצה, החייל שנפצע, הקדוש ברוך הוא ישמור אותו, יקום את דמו. ובעזרת השם, I want again to say הצלחה to Mrs. יוכבת בת דבורה, and of course רפואה שלמה לכל עמך ישראל, to all the people we mentioned, and to all of you, שנה טובה. I'm Rabbi Dahan here, כולל ברוך אהבת ישראל in San Diego. Please share the class with everybody. Thank you so much for being with us. Really appreciate it. Have a wonderful rest of the week. We'll see you again tomorrow and the day after. תודה רבה. God bless you all.